We are in the process of the law, and we have a whole lot of working heads committee who are in the process of prioritising an exercise on public service expenditure for making any decisions on consistency priorities. We're now at a situation where we have now reached that point, and budget spending options for 2013-14 are starting to develop. See, Wirral Public Service Board and four operational local public service boards are established and supporting the development of the neighbourhoods programme. Regular meetings are being held with internal audits who are providing support regarding governance issues, risk management, financial guidance, and constituency committee processes. Two risk management workshops have been held in order to develop a formal risk register made for the neighbourhoods programme. The next quarter will see a constituency review. Consistency committee's cabinet review is back. Wirral Improvement Board review. The governance handbook developed by each one of those committees. Annual report will be presented to each one of those committees. The draft outcomes focused on consistency plans developed by each committee, and the council's new commissioner's strategy to be implemented by each committee when commissioning priority activities. The sticking point at this present moment in time, I'm just looking to see Mr. Armstrong, he's up to. Was over the locations, and everyone was sticking points, which is developed. However, Wallasey have settled on their accommodation options at the police overwhelming centre. Wirral South at this present moment in negotiations over where they will be deployed to. Wirral West, in the short term, the team will be based in the Bullerbeck in order to support the Open Golf tournament. Longer term, the asset management team are assessing deployment options to either Woodchurch and West Kirby Concourse. And in Birkenhead, in the short term, the team will be based in Birkenhead Fire Station. Longer term, the asset management team will review the option of deploying to the new Utah. The next steps, consistency is to be deployed by the end of March 2014. Deployment of street team and community safety staff and activities by the end of March 2014. Decisions required on the next services deployed to consistency level will be taken. Community engagements following the budget options consultation exercise during September to December 13. Consistent teams are developing a community engagement framework which will be implemented from February 2014, which is not underway. The framework includes how the teams will engage all stakeholders across all the functions, something that very believe is something we must get right, absolutely smack on. Asset-based community development is being explored by its consistency area as a way of mapping existing and future assets within communities, i.e. people, buildings, resources, etc. etc. The next steps for quarter four are following full implementation of the new community engagement framework, communication strategy completed for each constituency, ABCD events within the communities, all reports of constituency residents issued to be uploaded onto the CRM system, and the constituency committee community representatives are being invited to attend appropriate members' training sessions by the members' training steering group. Can I say, Chair, I'd like to put on record, I think it's a very exciting time in the way the programme is being developed. I think that there was an element which basically said that the area forums were there before and were X amount of money. I think this is a totally different thing altogether to the area forums, and one where I believe where Harry just mentioned X amount of money is being devolved down from the street team out to the city. I'm just saying, as I did say at Council on Monday night, The likes of some of them have now become behold £15 million of their super constituencies. And I honestly believe the way the council is being taken and the future council, I can see this being a very big, important, major part of what we're trying to develop for this future council.
Okay, thanks, George. Alex, do you want to get
it? Let me say something. I mean, I fully endorse what George said. And as Dan said earlier, I mean, it's changing the culture and the mindset. And sets as well, part of that. Of unparalleled change, as George has said. It's certainly the unparalleled culture of Wirral Council. I think also the constituencies committees will provide us with a platform through this massive and radical change. That we're embarking upon, you know, because there's opportunity to be creative within this process, as George has said, to stimulate that creative debate within the constituencies committees. And it's the old saying is that it's not what the cry goes up, and it's not what the council can do, but what we can do in community. And more that's actually going to happen. I really do believe that. And I think those are based on the track. You know, within the constituencies can lead the way on this as more and more services are evolved, and we heard some earlier on from Harry. And I think also and I thought that there's lots of examples of that within our community where communities are doing it themselves. Voluntary, and there's some within my own board at the moment, and they want to do it, they're asking us to do it. I think that's good, and we're encouraging them to do it as well. And I think lastly, I mean, the elected members with that mandate as well, keep saying this, have such an important role to play within all of us to help shape and mould their services and lead the communities with that democratic mandate to help lead the communities through these unprecedented changes and to ensure, lastly, more and more, as we said, services are devolved to the benefit of our communities.
Okay, and I think we've kind of definitely sort of got these constituency committees sort of well and truly kind of embedded now in the new governance arrangements. I think our challenge is to devolve now more responsibilities, more funding, and get not just board members but local residents involved in determining the priorities for their area. I think this is about genuine localism, I think. And I think we've made a good start, but you know, still lots of work to be done. So thank you for that, George, and that's really helpful. So we're just being asked to note the progress of the Neighbourhoods programme. No doubt we'll get further progress reports in the coming weeks and months. So can we note that report?
Agreed.
Okay. Right, not been informed of any other business, so I will thank Cabinet for their attendance and close the meeting.